Hiya, how you doing? Have you done something fun yet? Well, let's do something fun together. Like, yes, we are going to do bezels today. I don't know if you watched my last video, I teased you with the bezels. And then we did something completely different. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm not going to put you through the annoyance of sitting and watching me do these bezels, because it's a very simple process. I'm going to be using this little container, and I'm going to be putting some blobs of resin in there, using either mica powder or colorants or inks to color the resin, and then I'm going to be using a little pointy tool. Let me just find my pointy tool. Where's it gone? There it is. I'm just going to be using a little pointy tool to pick up the bits of resin and carefully put them in to where I want them to go. Now these might have to use a different piece of sticky because these aren't sticking. Oh, they are. Are they sticking? Yeah, they are sticking. Just me. Okay, so yeah, I've picked a bezel from various different Sophie and Toffee boxes, so they're all different. I think this one's from the Cinderella box, this one is from Little Mermaid box, this one is from the Villains box, and this one is from the Good Vibes box. So, you know, nice variety. I'm going to do various different colours, whatever, to be honest, comes to mind at the time. I've got no plan with these. I'm just going to have fun, and then I'll come back and show you the results. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in a minute. Hi, how you doing? I'm back. It's, believe it or not, 4 days later, and I'm literally hoping to get this done, the rest of this video done tonight, so that I can upload it tomorrow. I'm not great at faces, but this is how Ariel turned out. I'm quite pleased with her. Maybe I should have done the eyes a bit higher, but that's literally as good as my faces have ever got. This is how Cinderella turned out. Really like that, she's really pretty. I haven't domed any of them yet because I usually fail on my doming. I managed to sort it out, but I just wanted to show you them while they were still pretty. If the doming goes successfully, I will show you some more pictures at the end. Okay, yeah, my hands just shake and the doming ends up flicking everywhere, so I'm gonna do my best and give it another go. We'll see. And then it's the lotus flower. I really like that. It's a little bit unusual colouring, but it's pretty and I like it. And then his Ursula. And yeah, I had a few disasters with this one, and I'm gonna go through them now. As you can see, you might be able to tell, you might not be able to tell. I'm hoping I corrected it well enough. Basically, I filled the hair in. Now, I put quite a lot of pigment in the small amount of resin that I'd done to do her hair. And I didn't do enough, so I had to put more in to fill this part in. And then I went and filled this part in, which I realised wasn't her hair. So I had quite a bit of resin left over that was all white, and I didn't need white for anything else. So I thought, let's not waste it, let's be clever. Let's just put some purple pigment in so that I can do the purple part. Yeah, awesome. Except, no, Marie, there was too much pigment in for the amount of resin that I put in, which meant only the top sealed, the inside still stayed gooey, and to the point that the liquid that was still inside pushed through, and I tried going over and over. I mean, I must have done it for about, I must have tried curing it for about 20 minutes on and off, you know, giving it some time to cool down and what have you, and still it didn't work. But luckily the back started to peel up, so I managed to get the top layer that had cured and peel it up as one piece and get the side bits peeled up, and then I cured what was left inside, and then I added a lot more resin to the pigment stuff that I already had. Did a small layer on top, cured that, in fact you can see there's still quite a dip in that one, cured that, and that's where I am. This that was white, I just did a thin layer of purple over the top, just to try and make it look okay. So this piece isn't great, I wouldn't give it as a gift, I'd probably keep it for myself. So I thought it'd be a good one to experiment on doing a really decent face and seeing if I can get a bit more than this, than dots, as I've done with this one. So, you know, let's have a go. I'm going to try using some resin. Yeah, this is white crystal art resin for the whites of the eyes, and then go in with some, I've still got some black left over here, go in with a bit of black there to make the pupils, and then I've got some eyeshadow, because she had like eyeshadow on there. I've got to make a pinky kind of I was hoping to make, oh no, that's it, this one. Let's go in and make sort of darker. I don't know what I'm going to do about the nose, to be too honest with you. I'll probably make that up as I go along. And then I've got a little bit of red to use for the mouth. Or at least, yeah, the outline. I'm not 100% sure on Ursula's face, so let's see how it turns out. It's probably going to be awful, but like I said, I made a total bugger up of this anyway, so we'll see. Okay, so just going to start with a little bit of this. I'm going to try going straight in. If this doesn't work, I'm not happy with this. Straight away, I've got one eye bigger than the other. Let's get another cocktail stick and see what I can do about that, because I don't just want them to be round. Okay. So I think that's a bubble, that's why. Right. Just want that to go out a little wee bit, but not too much. I'm going to take some off that one. The eyes are going to even out, but we'll have a look. I did consider buying some really tiny googly eyes, but I gave that up as a bad thing because I couldn't find any small enough. Okay, we're getting there. effect, but whose eyes are? Right. Kinda happy with the shape of that. Kind of. Let's have a look. Let's see how that does. I'm just gonna move these and hopefully do this. Get it cured enough so that a bit of bark will sit on there. Yeah, she does have bright red lips, does Ursula, doesn't she? Yeah, she does. Thinking about it. Solid enough. Okay. It's just right. Use some of this black. Like an eye, in some respect. There we go. That looks like two eyes. Right, we're getting there. Okay, yeah, that will do. So, I'm still practicing with faces. I'm not very good at all. I just wanted to try to tiny little bit. That should do. Should be enough for those. Right. She have yes, it's pale blue, isn't it? That eyeshadow that she has, I think. Right. Let's do this. Sorry, my hands are jittering. Left too much, just enough to do so. How's that gonna show up? For him to do maybe some a bit of black liner, maybe an eye. No, that's not the shape I wanted. Sometimes you do better when you're not worried about messes something up, because it's already not perfect, so well, if it doesn't work, it's the end of the world. Sometimes it takes that, just that fraction of pressure off you. And that should work. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, this is going to be the fun bit, to see if this works. Take that off and try again. Okay, here we go. Let's take that back off and try again. That's the beauty of making sure you flash cure each bit. Is that if you make a mistake like that, cure the eyeliner, get the eyeliner nice, cure the eyeliner, and then do little flicks for that, because I think it's all mixing in. I think that's what the problem is. Okay, good job, I've got plenty of this. Right, let's get this eyeliner right then. Eyelashes aren't coming out right. I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong. Too much on, maybe? Thank you. too thick. Right, what can I use? Think, Marie.
Think.
What can I use? Let's see if I've got tiny. Oh, let's see if a little brush will do. I don't really like using brushes. With resin, but let's see. Eyelashes. Because it's not. I think she's going to have no eyelashes at this rate. Because that just looked awful. Okay. Let's just keep going. I'll see if I can't. Something doesn't come to me about that. Okay. Let's just see about it. This is why I also don't wear makeup, because I'm blooming useless. There we go, happy with that. Don't want to go any further. Happy with that. Perfect for any stretch of the imagination, but it will do. Right. Let's get the mouth right and see what else we can do. Just want the tiniest of. Yeah, it's just not going to work, is it? No, it's just not going to work. Okay, right, let's do. She's definitely got a Cupid's bow. This is very liquidy. Let's add more in. Thank you. best I'm gonna get. Oh, sorry, a big sniff then. Yeah, I think that's the best I'm gonna get. So if you find that you're struggling with when you've added a lot of pigment, particularly powder pigment of any kind, add more resin to it, because the thing is, these are chemical compounds, and chemical compounds need to be able to react with each other to be able to, not scientists here, but just trying to explain it in as easy way as I can, need to be able to react with each other to be able to change its chemical makeup. So, if you're putting items in the way, they can be stretched, they can move around them, but if you put too much in the way, then they're broken and they can't make that change, so they don't change from a liquid to a solid, they stay as a liquid. That's why you end up with gooey matter. Okay, this is far from perfect, but like I say, with my hands, that's as good as you're gonna get. If you can think of any way, do you know what? I'm actually quite pleased with that. I would have loved to have got the eyelashes in there. They were just a mess. So, but no, I'm pleased with that. What do you reckon? For me, that's really good. Everything. But before I go, the next time you decide you don't like the way someone looks, just remember, when you take away all the squishy parts, we're all just skeletons, aren't we? Try being kind. The results might just surprise you. Thanks for watching.